I'm here with Jake, and I'm going to teach him about offsides in soccer. So, you need to be in offside position when the ball is played, and then you need to actually become involved in the play.
Alright.
What do you know about offsides, Jake?
I don't really know all that much about offsides. I used to play soccer as a kid, and what I remember was that it was nothing more than you couldn't be ahead of a defenseman when you didn't have the ball, so it wasn't cheerleading.
What do you think was the point of that rule?
I don't know. I play basketball with some kids down the street, and they always have one kid sit behind the latest defender, so when we score, they just throw the ball all the way down the court, and they do a layup and score, and it's really
nice. All right, and there are a couple different ways you can become involved. I mean, can you take a guess at what they are?
One is they pass to you and you go shoot the ball, or they pass the ball to you and then you start dribbling
so
further
playing,
down the field. Yeah.
Playing the ball, okay. Can you think of any others?
No, that's all I really know. So.
Okay, so say this guy has the ball here. He's onside. He can take a shot, but you're standing right there in front of the goalkeeper.
Oh, you're blocking the goalie from seeing.
Once you start interfering with play from an offside position, you can also be offside. Okay, so the basic theory behind that is that you don't want to be, if this is your striker, you don't want to be behind the defender because it'll be too easy to score and the defenders are not going to be able to have a fair chance to defend him. So can you go back and tell me what those three elements were?
First element is that you have to be on the wrong side of the, like, you have to be on the attacking side of the field. And you got to be behind the second to last defender. I know the last element you said there was that the ball has to actively be played to you.
Right.
I'm trying to think what the second element was specifically. I can't really remember.
Okay. So we're going to go ahead, and when you do this, you're going to go through 1, 2, 3 as you watch this. You're going to use that to sort of remind yourself as you watch this and determine whether or not you'll call this guy offside. So is he offside or not?
Yes.
Okay, why is that?
Because first he was behind the second to last defender.
Oh, here, let me bring
at approximately 17 seconds. He's behind all the defenders.
Okay. So that's number one. He's behind the defenders.
Time, like, it starts when he gets behind the player, really. And then he actually interferes by, like, playing the ball, which is, like, shooting the ball.
Okay. The timing is he's offside
as the ball
is played to him.
Yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
is he offsides?
No, because the ball isn't being played to him.
Alright, so you vote no. Alright, there's one.
He's not interfering.
Alright, how about this guy?
He's offside because he's interfering.
Offsides.
Yes. Yes. No, because he's not on the opponent's side of the field.
Okay, good catch.
No, because he's not, like, the balls. He's going to be... No, he's not offsides.
Alright, another one. You're 5 for 5.
Alright, this one? Not offsides again.
There you go. Doing good so far.
Not offsides.
Why's that?
Because it's a throw-in.
Alright, just making sure.
Not offsides. Kick. Free kick, or corner kick.
Be a goal kick. You can't tell though.
I can understand if the ball was on the ground and he was like lined up.
Yeah, but okay. So knowing that it's a goal kick.
Oh, knowing that it's a goal kick, no.
Okay. Alright. I was actually pleasantly surprised with my original video. I didn't know what I was doing. I was winging it. I wasn't very well prepared at all. And after all that, I actually ended up using several fairly effective learning theory techniques quite by accident. I used meaningful learning primarily rather than rote learning. There wasn't a lot of repetition or attempt at memorization. I tried to make connections with past knowledge, visual imagery, and sort of broader concepts of rules in sports to make the knowledge hit home. Overall, under the circumstances, I feel like we made the learning fairly meaningful and it stuck to some extent. I would say the learning strategies used to reteach the lesson were at least moderately effective. He passed the test at the end, and it wasn't a very simple rudimentary test. It did have some relatively complex elements to the test, and he was able to get a perfect score. So. And I'm quite certain that before we started on this, he hadn't seen a soccer game in years, so he would not have been able to pass that test, or at least do as well as he did. So to that extent, I think it was effective. I think the simulation was highly effective because it was entertaining, it was engaging, it was competitive, and it focused on applying the rule constantly. So in that respect, it was very, very useful. At the same time, I do wonder whether the reinforcement and punishment in the simulation had the right contingency. The rule was a constant focus, but the rewards and punishment were directed more towards effective timing and mastery of the controls than on actual knowledge of the rule. So while it was effective and it kept it in mind, the contingency wasn't directly related to the rule, so that wasn't necessarily what was being directly reinforced and punished. So that could have been, I don't know how I could have done that better, but it wasn't ideal. The organization and scaffolding, I think, was moderately effective as well. The main obstacle was a lack of time and resources. We only had a short amount of time to conduct the lesson, and I wasn't able to find many video examples of the rule in action. With more time and more samples, I would have been able to go over examples more extensively with the scaffolding and hopefully sort of drill that in a little more effectively to use the scaffolding effectively. And ideally, I would have... used prior knowledge and emphasize more meaningful knowledge in the way I did in the first video. I didn't do it as much in this reteaching of the lesson. First, because it was sort of redundant for the assignment, and secondly, because we didn't have time, and Jake, I didn't want to put him through it again. I didn't want to have him have to do, go over these same concepts and spend all this time sort of relating it when, for the most part, he had a sense of why all these rules were in place. But I do think if I had more time and I had more interest, I had more potential, I would have gone through and made more meaningful connections between each of the various points and the more detailed points I sort of skimmed over in this lesson. So I would have been able to have him able to adjudge offsides at a more advanced level.